You know, I hate doing negative reviews. And while some may consider that it is still important to do this sort of negative reviews, but I really wanted to avoid doing a negative review on this Nothing Phone 1. Because when the phone was launched, the software was a little buggy, and worst of all, the ultrawide camera and the main video camera stabilization looked like this. So I decided to wait for more than a month, patiently waiting for a software update to come. So, based on this software updates, are all of these so-called issues improved? Well, let's find out. Now, since I never dive into the specs in my full video reviews, here's a quick spec sheet of the variant that I have, so feel free to pause this video if you like to see it again. Yes, the reviewers were right. It does feel like you're holding an iPhone 12 onwards. And mind you, that is not a bad thing. Because of its flat screen and the square matte finish at the side, felt extremely nice and grippy in the hands to the point that I never had a sort of anxiety of dropping the phone. And yes, I did not use a case on the phone at all. And speaking of which, is there official cases available for this phone? Because not that I've seen. So probably go on Shopee and Lazada if you really need one. But yes, I did not use a case at all. Now, having used both the black and the white, I have to say that obviously I love the white, not because I just love white color smartphones and also because I love any tech item which is available in white, but the slightly greenish hue towards the side of the LED glyph lights on a black variant just made me feel a little turned off when I was looking at the rear of the phone, and since that is the main selling point, I did prefer the white compared to the black. Now, speaking of this glyph lighting interface, I'm going to be honest to say that I barely even use it as time goes by. Because I'm always the kind of person who either leaves the phone face up like this or in my pocket when I'm not using it. So while many people may benefit from this, I tried living with putting the phone face down, but I couldn't get to terms where the screen might get scratched, especially without a case to give that slight elevation to protect the screen. And while I did use Google Assistant a lot, which lit up the bottom part and followed my voice when I was saying a command, but once again, the thought of turning the phone around to see the reply was a little counterproductive. So this 6.55 OLED display was something that I grew to love the more that I use it. Just as a refresher, in case you did not know, that Nothing has decided to use a flexible OLED panel in order to keep the phone's bezels from the top, bottom and the sides to be symmetrical. And I feel that that really crazy effort was certainly appreciated. Now, watching videos on the phone was great, the screen was bright and the adaptive brightness was also very well adjusted no matter the lighting condition, and coupled with the 120Hz refresh rate and the touch sampling rate of 240Hz, using the phone daily was a really nice experience, and surely one of the key features of using this phone is the overall display. Next, onto the phone's cameras. A quick recap of the specs first. It comes with a main 50MP Sony IMX 766 sensor with an aperture value of f1.88. That is a 24mm wide lens with both OIS and EIS image stabilization. Then there's another 50MP camera which uses Samsung's JN1 sensor where it has an aperture value of f2.2. Then the front camera is a 16MP f2.45 aperture which uses Sony's IMX 471 sensor. So, did it improve, especially when it comes to the ultra-wide lenses? Well, on the left is an image before the update and on the right is after the update. So yes, there is a vast improvement, not only for the dynamic range, but the overall contrast and shadows have been significantly improved as well. So overall, I was very pleased with the ultra-wide lenses as seen over here. Now, the main lens was still my favorite lens even before the update, where all of the images did turn out really nice. And while some complained about the phone not having a dedicated telephoto lens, the 2x digital zoom still looked nice and sharp. But you will lose more detail when you zoom up to 10x. Now, portrait mode on objects was flawless, so it was for humans as well. Then as for the macro mode, while you can get up close and personal to get some very close-up images, but still I felt that it was still just decent. Nothing to really shout about, as you'll only get the sharpness right in the middle of the image where the sides was a bit blurred out. Then looking at the night mode, I still felt that the images here look quite mediocre, where I felt that the image processing really overcompensated on the highlights and shadows just too much. Now the quality of the main lens was better than the ultrawide lenses, and I've seen personally many other cheaper smartphones having better night shots on their phone, especially for the night mode selfies. Now as for selfie shots during the day, they look great, both on the regular and the portrait mode as well, with excellent age detection and overall dynamic range for the blurred background as well, even during a harsh lighting situation. Then looking at the video footage before the update, you can see that the footages look pretty shaky. And here is where I knew there was gonna be an improved software update, because the main lens has OIS. And thankfully, after the update, it was fixed, and the overall quality of the 4K video footage was also excellent as well. And here's a quick vlogging test using the phone's front camera for a vlogging situation, so check it out. Okay, so this is an audio test to see how well the Nothing Phone 1 records audio. When it comes to the visuals or the video quality, it has been improved vastly compared to how it was when the phone first came out. Now that's the reason why I always take my time in reviewing smartphones, because I hate coming up with negative videos. So this is definitely a good result in terms of the video quality, but let's see how it does when it comes to having audio recording for a vlogging situation. So that's the overall camera review, and do let me know what you guys think. Is this one of the best cameras within the price range? And if you're enjoying this video so far, a nice big thumbs up would be very much appreciated. And a subscription would be really sweet too. So nothing much, pun not intended, could be said about the software experience, as I just felt that it was extremely nice and just familiar. Coming from the OnePlus 5 days, I've always loved the old school iteration of Oxygen OS, and now on the Nothing Phone 1, you'll have a similar experience with easy to navigate menu system. And yes, you don't have to dive deep into the menu system just like how you do it on the MIUI skin. And yes, all of the bugs like the app closing by themselves and delay in scrolling on websites has all been fixed. Now as for gaming, my usual tests were on Genshin Impact and PUBG Mobile. And the gaming experience was great without any issues based on those settings, which was something that I kinda expected with this mid-range smartphone's chipset and the overall performance as well. Then since PUBG Mobile is a game that is always optimized very well with mid-range smartphones, it did perform well. And the graphics settings were at HDR and the frame rate was set to Ultra. Now the battery life on the Nothing Phone 1 is another solid highlight of the phone, where the battery drain was at the optimum level, where I got a whopping of 11 hours and 5 minutes when I was at 10% battery with dark mode turned on. Now compared to many mid-range smartphones, this phone has wireless charging up to 15 watts and 5 watts of reverse wireless charging, and it gives you 33 watts of charge through wired charging, and the charger is included inside of the box. So in conclusion, who is this Nothing Phone 1 for? Well, in my humble opinion, it's kind of a phone with such a masculine design, but the features may not be appealing for most people. Now, I humbly feel that things like using the Glyph interface for notification and such are only for a certain amount of people, and using the light to light up images for short does not give you proper justice because of its so not great image processing at night anyways. So hopefully, a next software update could fix this. But I feel that this phone could be appealing for any TikTokers or Instagram content creators who are up and coming, who does not necessarily need a higher flagship phone. But that being said, with a starting price of 2,399 ringgit, it's quite a tough challenge to go against other mid-range smartphones, which has more features.